how to script Amazon products without even writing a line of code? Well, you can do it with Octoparse. It's a free tool, you can find the link to download it just below. Scrapping products in Amazon.com is actually a good way if you want to make a product comparison. And if you want to scrape this website in Octoparse, we first need to enter the URL. Let's suppose that today I want to buy a new laptop. I simply copy the URL and I paste it in Octoparse. And to start our task, I click on start. Well, so far so good, right? As you can see, we've got here an overview of the website we want to scrape. And the first thing we need to do is to create our own workflow. In other words, we need to select all the non-sponsored products we've got on this page. To do that, I first need to create a pagination, so I click on the button Next, and I click on Loop Click Single URL. And then I set up an Ajax timeout of 10 seconds. We've got our pagination. It's time now to select all the non-sponsored products we've got on this specific page. And look, the first item is a sponsored product, so I'm going to skip it. Same thing for the second one, it's a sponsored product, so I forget about it. The third one is okay, so I select the block of the third item and it's highlighted in green, that's good. Then I'm heading to the fourth item, I select the block of the fourth item, and now this little pop-up shows me that 16 elements have been highlighted. And 16 elements is the exact number of non-sponsored products we've got on this page. So to select them all, I click on extract text of the selected element. We are now able to create our own workflow. That's awesome. But the thing is that we can already scrape some useful information, such as the name of the product, of course, but also the star ratings and the price of the product. I'm going to scrape these three elements. Let's start with the name of the product. I click on the name and I click on extract the text of the selected element. And if we verify, here are the name. That's pretty much the same thing for the star ratings. I click on the star ratings and I click extract the text of the selected element. And now we have a third column showing the star ratings. If you want to know another way to get the star ratings, you can click the link in the info box. That's pretty good for now, but I want to clean this column a little bit. Basically, I want to transform 4.4 out of 5 stars into just 4.4. That's not mandatory, of course, but that will help me to make this column a lot easier to read. To do that, I click on More, then Clean Data. And here is the input. I click Add Step, Replace with Regular Expression. I'm going to copy-paste what I want to remove, in our scenario, out of 5 stars. I paste it here, I click on Confirm, once, twice, and I click on OK. And now it's a lot better. Last but not least, and the most important element we want to scrape, is the price of the product. I click on it and extract the text of the selected element. And now we are good. I just need to remove, to delete the first column because we don't need it anymore. And I'm going to rename the fields. So I type name, I type rating, and I type price. We are good now, but I'm pretty sure you want to get more data. This is why we will click into each product link in order to get more information. So I click on the title of the first item and I simply click on click element. And as you can see, we have access to the detail page. And I want to get some additional information. Actually, I want to know 4 things. The first one is the level of inventory. The second one is not written here, but in some cases you've got what we called a list price. If we check another page, we can see it just here. It means that you've got a discount. And same thing, if we got a discount, I want to know how much money I could save. And last but not least, I want to scrape what we call the ASIN, which could be defined as an identification number. And to get all this information, we need to write an XPath. I know that XPath could be pretty intimidating for some people, but it need not be. For instance, let's start with the level of inventory. To get the level of inventory in Octoparse, I need to make a right click to click on Inspect. Then I will select the In Stock text. I make a right click again, copy XPath, and that's it. Then I simply need to go back to Octoparse. And I'm going to select something random. Really, something random. It doesn't matter. For instance, I select this text, extract the text of the selected element. Then I click on More, Customize XPath. I remove the current XPath and I paste the new one. And I click on OK twice. And as you can see, now we have access to the level of inventory. Let's move on and let's scrape the identification number. And this one is a bit specific because it's located via a nearby text. In other words, we need to tell Octoparse, find this XPath and then find its siblings. Because if we find this XPath, we are pretty sure we will find this data. Same thing. If you want to know more about how to scrape data via a nearby text, you can click the link in the info box. So, in order to scrape this data, we need to make a right click, inspect. We click an ASIN, but this time we are not clicking on copy XPath, but on copy element. Then we open a Word file, so I invite you to do the same, and we will simply paste the element and it looks like this, and we should end up with something like that. In other words, the name of the tag, the name of the text following sibling plus the name of the tag of the sibling. I know it looks difficult, but actually it's pretty simple once we have understood the structure. For instance, here the name of the tag is TH, which is located at the beginning and at the end. So we replace tag by TH. We keep contain text and we need to find the text. The text is pretty simple. It's ASIN, it's written just here. So I replace text by SAIN. Then I need to find the tag of the following sibling. To find it, I need to go back to Amazon. And as you can see, the tag of the following sibling is just this one, is TD, just here. So I type TD and I keep the one. And that's it. You know, it's not that difficult. All we need to do is to verify that the XPath is correct. So I copy the new XPath and I will use a Chrome extension which is called XPath Helper. So I paste the new XPath and as you can see, the result is just here. Now it's time to go back to Octoparse and same thing, I will select another element no matter of what it is, for instance this one, extract the text of the selected element, then I click on More, Customize XPath, I delete the current one and I paste the new one. I click on OK once and twice. And here is the identification number. And that's it. Now we redo the process for the list page and the discount. For instance, here is a list page. In some cases, it's located near the text list price, but in other scenarios, it's located near the text was. And we need to get both XPath. So I click on inspect. And I'm going to select this XPath. I click on copy, copy element, and here is the result. So the tag here is TD. I type TD, the text is list price, I type list price, and the tag of the sibling is also TD. So I type TD, and this is one XPath. And if we verify it with the Chrome extension, we can see that it's correct. But if we copy this XPath and we paste it in order to find this piece of information, it will indicate an error. Because in that case, it's not the word list price, it's the word was. So I simply replace list price into was. And as you can see, it's now written the correct price. So we've got both XPath, that's perfect. I copy the first XPath, same thing, I'm selecting a random piece of information, extract the text, I click more, customize XPath, I remove the current one and I paste the new one, I click try alternate XPath, and in that case I will copy paste the second one. Here we go, I click on OK once, twice, and in that case we've got an empty cell, which is totally fine, because if we verify, this particular product doesn't have any discount. Now this is almost over, all we need to get is the discount. So same thing, inspect, I select the XPath of you save, copy, copy elements. The tag here is TD for both. The text is you save. And that's it. And if we verify it, it's correct. That's perfect. I go back to Octoparse. I select something random. And you get the thing. More. Customize XPath. I paste the new XPath. OK once. OK twice. And it is done. Now this is over. All we need to do is to click on save, to run our task, and if you are a premium user, you can click run in the cloud. Otherwise, we click on run on your device. The data extraction is now over. I've already downloaded the file and it looks like this. As promised, we've got the name of the product, but also the rating, the price of course, the level of inventory, its identification number, and in some cases, the discount price. Hope my video got your confusion cleared away. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more videos regarding Octoparse and web scraping. We will always keep you updated.